What's going on, Canes fans? You know what time it is. It's game day! The Miami Hurricanes are taking on the imitation Miami of Ohio.
What's their team name again? The red something? Or was it blue? Maybe it was blue. Or maybe it was purple? Anyways, I can't remember. Nobody really cares. Miami of Ohio something. I mean, when you put Ohio in there, Miami fans just, we just don't care. They're nobody. We don't care what they have to say. We don't care about what they're about, what they say they're about. It don't matter. Welcome, Miami Hurricanes fans, my college football family, to the kickoff of the 2023 Miami Hurricanes virtual season. Are y'all hype? Or are y'all hype? Come on, man. I'm really pumped for this one. This is always so much fun every single year. This is our fourth year doing this thing. And I'm going to take just a moment, okay? I know Coop is fashionably late as usual, but I want to take just a moment and explain exactly what this thing is for all of the new people before we jump into it. Now, just a heads up, this thing lasts about an hour and a half. Just to give you an idea, I hope you've got your pizza, you've got your wings, you're ready to go. The tailgate was lit. I'm freaking hyped, man. I got to give some shout outs to everybody who was here bright and early to kick off the stream. Of course, Mama Coop in the building. She made it before she decided to go hit the hay. I got to give some shout-outs also to some Canes fan members who re-upped a Burgos. Does that really say 30 months, my man? Appreciate you for the love and support. And what did you say, 10 win minimum this season for Mario Cristobal? 10 wins, no BS, nothing more to say, Mario. Okay. All right, hey, Burgos. Okay. Man, look, I like the enthusiasm holding him accountable, right? I dig it. Adam Sadowski. Happy Friday, Coop. Re-upping the Canes fan membership. 6 months. Adam, thank you for the love. Thank you for being a part of the Canes fam. I appreciate you, bro. And also a new Canes fam member, King David 689. Let's get a nice warm welcome to King David. Appreciate all you guys. Enjoy those Canes fam member only emotes. And then, of course, as the season approaches, we'll have some Canes fam member only benefits and things that we're going to crank out for the 2023 season. So let's give a brief rundown here on how this thing works, and then we're going to get the ball rolling and we're going to kick this thing off. So let me just ask a real quick question. Who is new here? And by new, I mean, is anyone new to the simulations? Be real with me. Are you new here? Yes or no? Let's get an idea. Hold on. Hold on. Let me grab a chair. Let me know if you're new here. Let's see. Maybe not. There may not be any new people here to The Sims. Matthew is new to The Sims. Let's see. Simulation vet. I know, Thomas. I got you. Go Tigers. You ain't new here. Come on now, bro. So here's the deal. Here's what we'll do. I'll describe how this thing works just in case there are a couple of new people here. So what this is it's NCAA 14 with the revamped mod, which means that this has updated visuals and it also has the updated 2023 rosters. We do 8-minute quarters. Now, the reason for that is because it keeps the stats the most realistic that we possibly can. Keep in mind, at the end of the day, this is a video game. However, sometimes it does some weird, wonky, crazy stuff that's out of my control. And it's all out of my control because we do CPU versus CPU. Coop does not play a part. So my skill level does not determine who's going to win this game. Also, no player can wear number 0. I need you guys to keep that in mind. There's nothing I can do. I was able to fix the number duplicate thing. So, you know, Nathaniel Joseph will be number 5 and Cam Kitchens will also be number 5. I need you to also keep in mind that at some positions, we have to make an executive decision. I mean, you know, who's going to be the 2s? Who's going to be the 3s? Coming out of spring, we don't have all the answers for every single position. So for some of them, we just have to say, you know what? For the simulated season, it's going to be this guy. So for instance, at the running back position, Henry Parrish is going to be RB number one. And for the time being, Don Chaney Jr. is RB number two. If I'm not mistaken, I think it might be Mark Fletcher at three. I know people are really excited about Johnson. They're excited about Citizen. But we don't really know at the end of the day. So you have to understand it's not about who is on your wish list to be the starter. It's trying as hard as we can to keep it realistic as we can, given that it's a video game. So CPU, it won't be Terry Porter. You ain't wrong, man. Terry Porter not even playing a single down as a Miami Hurricane. Leaves a couple months after spring ball. Very odd, but, you know, I just say, peace out, bro. Good luck wherever you go. Miami will be just fine, you know? Canes today, I really appreciate that hype video you did on Twitter. That was sick. That was freaking sick, man. Thank you for that. I love when people do that kind of stuff. Julian, how do you become a member? That's always optional, my friend. If you want to, though, there's a join button by the subscribe button, or there's a link in the description. But never feel obligated. That is how you get the U beside your name and access to the emotes. So I know there's a lot of new people that said they were going to be here tonight. I'm really pumped and excited for this thing, man. Miami versus Miami of Ohio. Last year, the simulations had Miami going 9-3. But let's be real. I think the simulation was a little hype on Miami as well. You know, with all those star-studded names on the roster and on the coaching staff. But I need you guys to understand that even though it is a video game at the end of the day, we do like to hype it up and treat it like real game day. We're kicking off in T-minus 5 minutes, guys. Sometimes the simulation is way off. Sometimes it's scary accurate. Last year, Miami did beat MTSU in the simulation, but they only beat MTSU by 4 points. Do you want to know how many Canes fans were in this stream in June last year and told me that this simulation was the dumbest thing they've ever seen because there's no way Miami was only going to beat MTSU by 4 points? Now, I know Miami ended up losing, but everybody thought Miami was going to win by 20, 30 plus. They only won by 4 in the simulation. So, what's up, Crack That Head? Good to see you, bro. I'm Max in the building. It's good to see you guys, man. Really, really good to see everybody. I like to wait till we have at least 100 people in the stream before we kick off. We're already over that number. So, without further ado, are y'all ready to do this? Are you really ready to kick off the simulated season? And of course, as always with every stream, no obligation to support. I just appreciate everybody being here hanging out. But Super Chat is active for these just like it is for the regular live streams. It'll pop up a message. It'll read it out loud for everyone to hear. No pressure to ever do that. I just like to make it known. The join button is beside the subscribe button. People are going to ask this every stream. I like to plug it in at the beginning and the end just as a reminder to people, but never feel obligated to do so. So without further ado, what's up, Cypher? It's good to see Cypher in here. I'm nervous for all these. Chris Kane for life. I'm going to be real with you. Kane in the desert. I get nervous for every single one of these things because after last year, I don't know what to expect. Honestly, I'm very nervous. Oh, 8 minute quarters, Heisman difficulty, CPU versus CPU, 75 degrees and sunny at Hard Rock Stadium. I don't have the new scoreboard Canes today because it's too buggy. It's too buggy, unfortunately, so we have to rock with, I think this is version 20, something like that. So guys, the 2023 simulated season. Oh, and by the way, yes, starting tomorrow, I am actually going to be controlling Miami. We're going to do a Coop Plays series. Where is it? Right here. We're doing a Coop Plays series tomorrow, Saturday at 9 p.m. Eastern time. Coop will be controlling the Miami Hurricanes. It'll be super chill. Guys, it's not becoming a gaming channel. Don't freak out. but it's just going to be super chill so we can hang out, and I will control Miami tomorrow. Tonight, it stays like normal. We're doing the actual full-on simulation, CPU versus CPU. But I want to showcase my skills. You know what I'm saying? So here we go, y'all. We've got the siren out. We're ready to treat this thing like a real game. Let's freaking go. We got, is that Chalupa Batman? Is that the Chalupa in the building? I've seen this man on the You Heard podcast. I've seen him on Locked On Canes with Alex. Always dropping player breakdowns on Twitter. My man. Good to see you, bro. Very excited to have so much of the fam here tonight. Hyped and ready to go, man. Now, let's see. Last year, the Miami Hurricanes virtual team struggled in the red zone offensively. That ended up being the case during the season under Gattis. Let's see if they improve it this year. I freaking hope so. Let's go, y'all. Here it is. Miami versus Miami of Ohio, baby. Here we go. Yeah, I did the wrong time. I don't like to set it tonight in the game because it makes the visuals look really funky. So every game will be 12:30 in the simulations. So what we do is I actually change it to CPU versus CPU on the stream so that way everyone knows I'm not BSing. So settings, select sides, Coop's hands coming off the controller. We treat this like the real thing, guys. If you're new here, if Miami scores, we celebrate, we crank the siren. If Miami does bad, we're honest and we trash talk and we criticize. People even tagged the players on Twitter, and Restrepo and Andy both told me that they saw it. Whenever we did it last year, Restrepo caught a game winner. He was like, bro, I loved it. It was the coolest thing ever. So they see this stuff. They see it, man. Chase Hamilton, before we kick this thing off with the 499, this thank you for that, bro. I appreciate you.
On the side of your helmet.
30.
I work as a microbiologist and have to be up at 4:30 in the morning, so I'm super sleepy, but I decided to stay up just for this.
Let's freaking go, man. Chase Hamilton, thank you for the top dono of the night, my man. I'll sit you atop your throne. Microbiologist in the building. 4:30 is too early, though, man. I don't know about that one.
The quarterback leads.
I appreciate you, Chase. Here we go, guys. First look at Guidry's defense.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
Thank you, Chase. I appreciate you, bro.
This is what it takes. To where do you?
Let's get it.
Sorry, your helmet.
Second and six.
Two.
Ball on the 29-yard line.
Brandon coming in and instantly stealing the throne. Little handoff. Okay, third down. Third down on this first possession here. Brandon Frick, let me fix that for you. It didn't read it like it should have. I'm nervous too, bro. I'm nervous too, man. Thank you for the love, Brandon Frick. Big time supporter. That man don't play. Bjorn's definitely here. Oh, yeah. Redhawks moving the ball. Come on, LT.
Back to him, and he gets,
I know you've been hitting the weight room, bro.
The running back gets a yard, maybe less.
Keep your eyes peeled for some of these freshmen. Some of these guys that might come in and make a play. Come on. I don't know why I'm sitting for this. I can't sit for these things. Yeah, keep an eye out for the young guys.
Okay. Throw, incomplete pass.
All right.
The defense gave him little time to make a good decision.
So he made a bad one. That's when you just throw the ball out of bounds.
Does everything look good and sound good, guys? If I can get a couple of audio people to give me some feedback here right quick. Big third down.
Got pass.
Let's go.
Davis.
First look at the Canes offense. Hey, Chalupa, I think your guy, Ray Ray, is returning punts. Thank you, Adam. Thank you, Cypher. I think it's Ray Ray back there. Well, he ain't going to get to return that one. But
I'm sure the fans are thrilled to see their guys come up with an early stop in this game.
It's good to see you in here, Chris Gaffney.
Give them something else to get excited about.
Here we go. First look at the offense, guys. The virtual offense.
There he is.
The 31-yard line. They'll get two on that one.
And a great job. Ray Ray starting game one right now.
Anything with the ball after the catch.
We got Hoodie Girl in the building saying what's up from work.
Five wide receivers.
We're on third and eight already. Melissa, don't work too hard, my friend.
Ball on the 31. They'll spread the field with five.
Thank you for stopping in and saying hello, though. We need the Hoodie Girl here.
Incomplete pass.
This quarterback has got to do a better job of looking off defenders and allow his covered receivers some room to improvise and get free.
Uh-oh. The new punter also. Another Australian, but he's not tatted up.
Right down.
Defense back on the field. TVD almost threw an interception. I mean, we got to think. First time running the offense,
in a tie game.
There's going to be some jitters, even if it's Miami, Ohio. Let's be real. This is nice here, my man. First time checking it out. Hey, Brandon, it's all about having fun.
You can't take sacks like that.
I try to remind people, Brandon, that we treat it like game day,
get out of the pocket,
but the goal is have fun. If you're not having fun with these since it's the virtual season, then you're doing something wrong. Bench TBD.
All on the 38-yard line.
Oh, man. Here we go. Fire Dawson. Oh, who got trucked?
The 40.
Oh, snap. All right, big third down already. We're going to settle in, guys.
They'll line up with five wide.
Have a good night, Melissa. We appreciate you stopping in, for real. There we go, baby.
He's taken down.
There we go. We'll take that.
44-yard line.
We'll take that.
Get anything to work, and it will be.
That was Cam, right?
This is the kind of solid, consistent play you look
for. I know, man. I hate
it
that Chris is gone, Andy.
The offense can
Such a good guy. Such a good guy. It's so unfortunate. Here's Ray Ray Chalupa.
Joseph fields at the 17. They'll bring him down at the 28-yard line.
All right. We should be settled in.
I don't think either team has
second
a
drive on
so
offense
far.
Here, guys.
Let's see if, they can make some
plays. Let's see if we run the ball.
Separation.
Okay, we do.
Let's go.
Bring him down the 39-yard line.
Let's go.
Anytime this guy carries the ball and gets a little space, we could be
Parrish's first
six.
Run of the game, 11 yards, baby.
39-yard line.
Okay, we're going to run it again.
Parrish
looking good and healthy. All right, all right. You're right, Aiden. You're right, man. Remember, we're not going to be, guys, it might be balanced at times. We're going to run the ball when we need to run the ball.
Your instincts tell you to go for the pick. You've got to make the best play you can, and sometimes it's just batting the ball away.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards.
TBD got to settle in, though, bro. One for four. Right here, right here.
He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
TBD is one of five for two passing yards, guys.
The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
Joyce is waiting for the
one
snap.
Of five for two passing yards.
He makes it to the 25-yard line. Let's get some points going right now. Not a lot of offense here in the opening quarter.
I'm with you. I'd like to see a lot more offense than we've seen up to this point.
He threw that into double coverage too, right? Was nobody else open downfield or what's up, Nick 305?
Play with some focus.
Good to see you, bro.
Smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
Oh, this is a great job by this young man to get the ball out of his hands. He was facing an all-out blitz and didn't panic at all. It's a nice pass.
Miami, Ohio is going to come in with the chip on their shoulder. Like my grandma used to say, "Gots to be more better."
There we go. Let's go.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets
hit
like that.
Let's go.
We'll be surprised to see the old.
That's the intensity right there. That's what we want to see. Big hit.
That's Markeith, right?
Sheesh.
Hey, my hands are off the controller, bro. Second and 16.
Where are you? I'm sorry, your helmet.
Trying to figure out if a Florida State fan or Ohio State fan did the programming of our players in this update.
Third and long. Ball on their own 31.
Chris, taking over the board. I wouldn't freaking doubt it, man. Everybody's biased against that. That defense is settled in, bro.
Perfect time to call the blitz. He took a bit
of a chance, but
paid off by the linebacker being able to get through there, shoot the gap, and get to the quarterback.
We about to eat. This defense about to eat. I'm telling y'all, we just had to get settled in. Fourth and 24. Chris, I wouldn't doubt it. Imagine that whoever works with these rosters and stuff and tweaking this almost blocked. Come on, Ray Ray. We're at midfield. If we don't score here, I'm going to be livid.
Well, this is just a defensive battle so far, Kirk.
Well, huge possession right there by the defense, big time. Aggressive, fast, physical.
Get it going a little bit.
Love it. But it'd be so funny, Chris, but not funny because, you know, we talk about it's us against the world, right? Thank you so much for the $9.99, Chris. Appreciate you, bro. Dan McCormick. Okay, the Oregon transfer. I'll sit you atop your throne, Chris. I don't think many thought that was funny because they're worried that it could be true. Harris running hard. After what happened last year, this man is ready to put in some work. Chris, either no one got the joke, or they're just, I'm serious, they're just worried.
Nice run up the middle.
When are we going to see Chaney? We're going to have to give that man a breather.
They need about 3 yards to
there
get
it
the
is.
First.
Looking good up there, Chris. Looking good, Chris. Chaney, there it is. There's Chaney.
And he hits him hard at the 19-yard line.
If Chaney can stay healthy, baby. That's some combo right there. Defense looking good. TBD is struggling right now, King David. You got a good stable of backs, though, that can, you know, help kind of take some of that pressure off.
Gets it up the gut. Gets to about the 17-yard line.
Life of a Canes fan. Pure panic at beginning of every season.
From the 17-yard line.
You ain't wrong. Let's take a shot. Let's take a shot, bro. Right here. The X-Man. The X-Man. We're punching it in, guys. We're punching it in, I'm telling you.
Defender was in man coverage. As a defender in man coverage, you cannot get beat deep. And as a result,
I'm ready.
Underneath routes are going to be there.
Wait.
As you can see, it worked out great for the offense as they were looking
on
for
a
set of downs. It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a 5-yard
Who was the false start on?
Damage to a drive.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points
oh,
here.
Oh, man. Mario and Mirabal better be in somebody's ear.
Let's go.
You want to kill the momentum of a drive? The keeper by TVD?
And he's tackled after
you want to kill the momentum of a drive? You get in the red zone there with that pass to Restrepo, and then you get a false start?
Five wide.
Typically, the Canes would walk away with a field goal here because of that. PVD's struggling.
I think the quarterback that time just felt the pressure and just got rid of the football before he took the sack.
PVD's struggling bad. We're third and goal, bro.
Please.
Ready, three, 19.
Looks middle.
Let's go. Let's go. Touchdown, Janie.
Touchdown, Miami.
Let's go.
The uprights with the extra point. A 9 point.
Let's go, man. I'm so happy to see Don Chaney Jr. He's looking good. He's feeling good. And he scores the first Miami Hurricanes touchdown in 2023 for the virtual season. Thank goodness for Chaney.
Up here, Brad, you can see their defensive speed, and they're just playing with kind of an aggressive attitude. They're going to have to maintain that to slow down this.
I hope that man eats this season. I really do. Imagine an entire season with Chaney injury-free. Come on, come on. Fast, physical.
Brought down at the 33.
I'm glad you're enjoying this, Brandon.
They're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
Chase, just read the scrolling text. I don't mean that in a mean way, but it'll explain.
They keep it on the ground with a tailback. Got an opening. Makes it out to about the 49.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space.
Can't lose the fake, Miami. They're playing hard. Miami of Ohio is definitely giving it their all.
Quick throw out to the receiver. The pass good for maybe 7 yards.
The defense wasn't too much by the play action, but it gave the quarterback just enough of a cushion to find his receiver.
Come on, man.
Second down. And
that hit was devious. Yeah, it was something else. A pick would be huge, man. Because they're driving right now.
And he dives
okay.
Forward.
Big third down here, y'all. Cam in there again. Cam still embracing that leadership role. Flying around the field. All right.
Not a lot of offense in quarter number one.
Starting the second quarter on a third and one. Let's go, Canes.
The Hurricanes in front.
Let's go.
7-0.
We need a big time stop right here.
And we're back.
Here we go.
Action here in quarter number two.
Here we go.
Third downs where it's third and medium, it gives the play caller a chance to run the football or to throw the football. And in this case, I didn't really think the defense
somebody step
back,
up
thinking about more the
somebody make a play on defense.
And the offense was able to take advantage of that and convert for a first down.
Nice run there.
Holding on, Miami, Ohio.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
They're giving away 3 yards and only making life
James!
Easy for the guys on the other side of the ball.
First down.
James!
Ball on the 18-yard line.
I have to call him James because there's multiple Williams.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. He gets hit out of
what's up, Zartan? Vigia games tonight. You right.
They look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
Oh no. Are they going to score here? Are they going to march down the field and score on us here?
That's the fifth first down on this drive alone. The big thing is when you have this kind of drive going, you don't want to end it in a field goal. Now, you want to focus on trying to put the football into
there we go. Driving back. Driving back. Come on now. Cam in there again. Cleaning up.
This is the 10th play of this drive.
Making bacon and watching Canes football.
So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers.
Bacon at 10 p.m. on a Friday night? I like the way you think, Chalupa.
They've been all over this quarterback.
Big play. Here we go.
Gore
making a play.
Give this defense some credit.
Okay.
Really
Harvey getting
they
in
have
there.
To do to pressure the quarterback and cause him some problems.
I don't know what kind of kicker they have, but let's keep pushing them back.
This is the 11th play of this drive.
I haven't seen that, Zartain. I did see where you linked it in Discord. I need to check it out. You said you can't get Miami, though, right? Anytime is bacon time. Fair. Fair. Thank you, Daniel, for the sub. Appreciate you, bro.
This one will fall incomplete.
Come on.
He would have took that to the house, too.
This one should be makeable.
I don't know what the roster's called, actually, Canes, today. I'll hit you up on Twitter if I can find out.
It's up.
He got it. He got it. All right, defense. After a drive like that to hold him to a field goal, we almost got a pick right there on that third down play. I'll take it. I'll take it. Hey, happy birthday, Chris. Oh, we got Robbie Washington back there. I think it's Robbie Washington and...
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to
Restrepo,
waste
maybe? Yeah, Chris, Miami it's on about a 60 to 90 day rotation. That's pretty accurate.
Tackle
yeah.
Decent run up the gut.
Yeah, Longhorn Steakhouse is good. Yeah, for sure.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Wait, do we got Miss Chalupa Batman in the building? What?
He's in trouble.
There we go, baby. Colby! Let's go!
This secondary better tighten it up. They're going to slow down this drive.
Now, remember, a lot of players changed numbers this year, guys. Colby Young is now number 4. Look at that, wide open. Man, if TVD didn't get flushed out of the pocket there, Colby might have taken it to the house. If he could have hit him in stride, but he had to kind of adjust and break his route off there. Either way, that's huge. We're past midfield, so we'll take it. I didn't know we had Miss CB in the building. Y'all making bacon together. Isn't there a saying?
Golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a short.
Isn't there one that's something like the couple that makes bacon together stays together? I'm pretty sure I've read that somewhere. Okay, third and 4. This is manageable third down.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about 4.
If we want to win more than 5 games this year, we got to convert these, especially against teams of this caliber. With the zip from TBD!
Touchdown, Miami!
To Bobby Washington!
Defense,
did y'all see the zip on that ball?
Speed by the receiver. Well, that had to be a miscue of some kind. Or
TBD's warming up. Listen, guys, it's the first game with this new offense.
I'm sure the defensive coordinator is going to want to get his defense.
You know what I'm saying? Even though
it's
going to be something more tailored towards TBD's skill set, it's still going to take some time. This is so much different than a spring game or a spring practice.
He kicks it off, and he got all of that one.
It's coming together, baby. Now we just need that defense to step up right here. Let's get the ball back in the hands of the offense. Let's make it 21-3. What's good, Scotty Digital?
Building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in.
Good to see you, my man.
Gets it out to his receiver.
Good tackle right there.
He's taken down.
Solid tackle. That was Devontae, right? I'm still trying to learn some of these new players' numbers, too. What an ugly ball. Was that Devontae or Damari? I think that's Devontae. Somebody hurt? That's what we want to see from Adam. Right, Tyler Van Dimes. Defense flying all over the field.
Fires out to his receiver. And down he goes around the 39-yard line.
Excellent execution on one side of the ball that time. And it looks to me like the defense was in a little state of confusion. Let's see
Hello?
If they can pull themselves together.
Did Daryl Porter Jr. just get outran by a tight end?
And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10.
51, Mike. Mike 51. And two.
That's a problem.
With a quick throw.
Is this man's speed 110? Hello? Nate, who? That's a wide receiver. I thought it was a tight end.
And a nice catch.
Well, this is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly, and again, the speed of the receiver is the
difference. That guy's
in this
way.
Play.
They got great concentration.
Somebody hacked my PlayStation.
That flag back.
This man is too fast. Flag on the play. Is that Jeremy Shockey? I thought it was a tight end, Chalupa. He's so big. That man's got to be like 6'7".
Smith fields it at the two.
Oh, it's Brashard back there. So no player can be number zero, guys. I think Brashard.
The offense will be hoping they can move the
Brashard
ball.
Brashard changed
well
his number, right? I think Brashard is now number zero, and I can't give anyone number
right
zero.
Now,
so
the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out.
Not MTSU all over again.
Bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look.
No.
On his heels as opposed to
No.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down.
Hey, Chris. Miami, thank you for some more love. I appreciate that, man. Strong pass to McCormick.
He's tackled at about the 47-yard line.
Okay, that's what it was, Chalupa. I have to remind myself since no one can be number zero in this game.
This is what it takes to wear the U on the side of your helmet.
I just threw up a little bit.
Me too. Me too, Chris. I didn't feel like throwing up tonight, but here we are. Thank you for the $1.99, Chris. I appreciate you.
Tackle made at the 46-yard line.
What's up, Ian? Parrish playing a big role in this game.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 46-yard line.
When does A.J. Allen get on campus? I'm not 100% sure, actually. Chaney just mowing through the defense. That man looks 100% healthy. Offense is rolling. Okay. Dump it off to McCormick. McCormick's got solid hands so far. I dig it. What's up, Kane for Life 75? I have a weird thing with numbers. My memory is trash, but if you ask me a player's number, I'll probably know it. If I know the player, of course, I'll usually know their college and pro numbers, too. That's wild.
They'll bring him down.
I have the memory of a Mongolian gerbil, Chalupa. Skinner is a better tight end. I mean, that's up for debate, though. You have to think. See, here's the way I approach the simulated season. I agree. I think Skinner is a freak athlete. But I have to think who are the coaches going to play, not who do I want to play. First Jacoby siding, and I think it might be McCormick or Arroyo that start. I think Skinner works his way into the rotation, though. I feel like it'd be tough to keep him off the field. There we go. Smart decision from TBD.
And he's tackled at about the 21.
Good decision.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 21-yard line.
We moving. Okay, keeping it again.
He gets out to about the 18-yard line. So they pick up three on the option.
As long
keeper.
As we can score going into the half the right drive. Now, that would be huge. Up 11, 21 to 10. Mark Fletcher is in the rotation. But I'm going to be honest. You have to think about this.
Right. He can't get back to the line.
Mark Fletcher, game one, does not start ahead of a healthy Parrish or Chaney. Do we agree or disagree? I'm not asking what people think should happen. I'm asking what does Mario Cristobal and this staff do. I don't think there's any way that those guys start ahead of Parrish or Chaney if they're both healthy. Just being realistic.
Pressure coming.
He should have just tucked that and run. First Andy signing for the field goal.
Virtual Lance Guidry must be livid right now.
Come on, Andy. We should be walking away with seven, but...
Kicks up, and it's good.
Andy's good from 55, so we know we're safe. It's up 17-10. My man, Scotty Digital!
And it goes into the end zone. Down.
He says, virtual Lance Guidry must be livid right now.
Last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards for the year. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy.
Virtual Lance Guidry is pissed right now, bro. Thank you very much for the $2 dono, Scotty Digital. Appreciate you, my man.
Really getting after the quarterback.
Helping to keep these streams up and running.
14 after the setback. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Oh, and he had some steam on that throw. And they make the stop.
We have time to get the ball back again here, guys.
Did you see how he looked that ball into his hands? That's how you catch a football.
They come out in a five wide set.
Yeah, see, that's the thing, Chalupa. A lot of times, it's great. Let's go!
Screen pass intercepted.
Let's go! No way!
Again. Touchdown, Miami! Touchdown, Miami!
Are you kidding me?
To bring the ball back for a
Porter
touchdown.
Read that all the way. My man was licking his chops from the moment they snapped that ball. That man was over there like a rabid dog just foaming at the mouth. He was red. He knew, bro. He's like, do it. I dare you. You know what? I forgive him for struggling to keep up with number 88
this one's going to be down
the on
the
Red Hawks. You know, he got burnt like two times. He couldn't bring that guy down. And that dude's like 6'7", 315 pounds. So I understand Porter not being able to take him to the ground. Pick six. I forgive him. DP2, let's go, Chalupa. Jeez.
All the good plays from this defense has helped them.
That caught me off guard, man. I wasn't ready for that.
This quarterback can put that last throw behind him.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful because this defense is...
What a hype virtual season already. Look at this.
They need to run
the team's feeding off the energy in Hard Rock Stadium.
This pursuit because this defense is coming after
the fans are hype and excited. Look at LT. LT doing backflips through the ground.
Looking to dig themselves out of a little.
That man's been hitting the weight room.
It's second and 14. They'll spread the field with five wide.
I thought up 11 at half was best case scenario, Cypher.
There's a strike complete.
There we go. Stop that clock.
He hits him hard at the
34. Oh, he didn't. He didn't. He did, Artis. I forgive him, man.
Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers.
I ain't seen a pick six in a while from the Canes.
Makes the grab, and he's got the first. Brought down right around the 38-yard line. From their own 38-yard
They're going quick.
Line.
They feel like they first can at down. Least walk away with three. Let's see.
Check, check.
And he just gets rid of it.
Nothing open downfield. Yeah, Phil, Porter got a pick six. You like it, King David? It gets me hyped up, man. Gets my blood pumping. Taking a shot. Okay.
No, incomplete.
Good D, good D, good D. You ain't throwing a can back there. Big third down right here. We've got a timeout still. Okay. Do we try to do something here?
D
defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open.
Let's see how this punt goes. Does Miami maybe?
Joseph,
return. I mean, I know what the real Mario Cristobal would do, guys. The real Mario Cristobal would be content up 14 going into the half.
Joseph fields it to 30. He makes it to the
38-yard line. Let's maybe look. Let's maybe do like a quick pass. We have one timeout in our back pocket just in case somebody maybe misses a tackle and we break free. And I'm just saying, let's see what happens right here. Okay, we're gonna do a screen, try to catch him sleeping.
Zips it to the back and he's taken down at the 41.
We still got that timeout. Right here.
He guns it to the left.
No way. No way.
Touchdown.
What? Are you kidding me?
Absolutely no problem finding the end zone.
The Canes are taking over. Colby Young with a huge touchdown.
To where the U. I'm sorry,
he makes the PAT.
Canes win. 9-1. Let's go baseball.
62-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. So the score now.
This went from 14-10 to 31-10 in the blink of an eye.
Keep this thing close.
You literally could have went to get a snack and come back, and you would think you missed an entire quarter of football. Am I right?
Hi, everybody. Glad
exactly.
To have you with us.
We are. Tell them, Chalupa. We are going vertical on people.
Presented by Nissan. Innovation.
To quote the great Kevin Beard,
Dave Pollock here in the studio, as
we're not
always
afraid to take shots. That's what we're doing in 2023. None of this Josh Gaddis BS. Let's play like this in the real season. It's funny, guys, because what happened last year in the virtual season a lot was people saying, how come we can't play like we did in The Sims? I liked the virtual, you know, plug in whoever. It was Josh Gaddis last year. They're like, I like the virtual Mario better. Look at that. 177 passing yards, 91 rushing yards, almost 100 rushing yards in the first half. I'll take it, given what happened last year. You saw J.D. DeBoss celebrate in his seat.
Tackle the guy and bring him to the ground. Too many missed tackles, too many explosive.
J.D.'s such a cool dude, man.
Like that, you should probably look him behind and say,
such, just such an awesome guy. Kind, man, him, Kane Fan Co., all those guys.
Everything going on in college football. Going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you.
Crazy way to end the first half. So the first half of the virtual season is a wrap, guys. First half of the first game. Excuse me.
Welcome back, everybody.
So we're about to kick off the second half of this ball game. The Canes up 31-10 against Miami of Ohio Redhawks. I got to give a shout out. Let these two donos play here right quick before we kick off. My man, Eric Birch.
This is what it take.
Coming in hot with the $2 dono. Eric, what's up?
Coop.
You added any more softball trophies?
This is what it take.
To the shelf?
To where do you?
Appreciate you, Eric. Thank you for the love, man.
Which Florida State fan was running his mouth earlier about losing this by 21?
This is what it take. To where do you?
He gone, Chris. He gone.
When Colby has a step from the 25, it's a wrap.
It is a wrap. It is a wrap, man. And you think, Scotty, think about what Colby was able to do last season. Now he has a whole nother year under his belt at the Power 5 level with the strength and conditioning under Aaron Feld. Colby, man, I'm telling y'all, everyone's talking about this guy and that guy and this newcomer. Are people forgetting about Colby Young? They're talking about he's not going to be able to get yards after the catch and this and that. I'm telling you, Colby is something special and could be very special. Unlimited potential from this guy. I'm telling you. transferred at Miami, really didn't get a shot till later in the season. Everyone said, where was that guy before? He's been adjusting to, you know, that this is next level speed, right? Going from JUCO, upgrading here to Miami. I'm telling you. Scotty Digital, thank you for the two, man. I appreciate that. Chris Gaffney, thank you for the $4.99. And Eric, thank you for the $2. I appreciate you guys. Thank you. Where the FSU fans at? Where they at? Hey, Steve, I appreciate you, man. Thank you for stopping in and saying hello. Don't work too hard. Promise me before you leave, you ain't working too hard. Otherwise, you can't go. Colby looks like a different player this year. He got in that weight room and went to work. He did. They're sleeping on him, Chalupa. It's like all of a sudden nobody's talking about him. Nationals? Let's go, Eric.
Let's go, bro.
Did you never pursue like college baseball or major league baseball or anything like that? I know you're big into softball, but let me know. Before we kick off the second half of this ball game, guys, I do just want to give shout outs to everybody who's here hanging out. Over 200 people in the stream. It's lit. It's already been so much fun. We're going to do this every single Friday at 9 p.m. Eastern time. One game a week, the entire Miami Hurricanes 2023 schedule. And also on Saturdays, I'm now going to do Coop plays where I will play the game that we played on Friday, but I will control Miami. That's going to be happening tomorrow, 9 p.m. Eastern time. That'll happen every week. And then shout out to the top dono so far on the night, Chris Gaffney at the $9.99. If you guys are enjoying the stream, you want to see these things continue, you can donate as well through Super Chat donation or the PayPal link that pops up in the chat. Never feel obligated or pressured to do that. I'm just letting you know. Thank you guys for all the love and support so far. Let's get it. What's up, Cajun Kane?
About to begin. Washington's deep to return.
Everybody's always questioning if Coop can play the game. Tomorrow we'll find out. Brashard? Was that Brashard? No, that was Robbie. There's so many sets of brothers, guys. You got Devontae and Damari. You got Robbie and Bobby. You got the Malgoa brothers. There's going to be a lot of mixing up names this season. A lot. Massive hole for Parrish. We've now surpassed 100 yards rushing in the first game of the season. What's going on, Mark? It started out kind of slow, and then as the team settled in, we're taking control. Basically, what we want to happen in the real season, Mark. Look at that. Beautiful.
To where are you?
I'm in love.
I'll be playing in Nashville August 3rd through the 6th. Ooh. Would like to catch up.
You know what, Eric? Let's do that. Thank you so much for the five, Eric. Appreciate you, bro. Let's like actually do that. Like
the cavalry's coming, and he is okay.
Got some pressure on TVD. It's gonna happen. The O-line has been playing a lot better once the second quarter took off, though.
Slide up into my DMs, Eric. Or text me. You got my number. Text me, bro.
In the second down and long situation.
Let's make it happen. What are y'all arguing about COVID year? Chaney with the vision. That man making it look easy. My man Chaney's out there like, excuse me, bro. Coming through, out the way. Look at him, he ain't even tired. Sean Kelsey, what's up, man? It's good to see you. I see you and the fam have been doing good. We're friends on Facebook. I see
this
the pigs. Appreciate you stopping in, Sean.
You. From the 17-yard line.
I'll be in Nashville August 3rd through the 6th. Would like to catch up playing there.
Did you mean to send that again, Eric? Look, we have to appreciate the vision from Chaney, but also look at these holes and running lanes being opened up by the offensive line. Am I right or am I right? Coming out in the second half of this game and just running it down their throats, man.
They go with the runner. He's
I want to be able to come out in games, right? We do want to go vertical. We want to throw the ball. We want 300, 400, 500 passing yards a game. But I also want to be able to come out and just assert our dominance. You need a good, solid run game to lean on. We need that. We need that chemistry with the O-line. We need those guys.
He's tackled around the 6-yard line. That's
good for a game. Can it be September?
It's the ninth.
Thank you, Eric. I don't know if you meant to send that twice or if it bugged. Thank you for the love, man. Thank you. We'll make it happen.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
It's fourth down. This one should
be
makeable.
We want it. We still want to make it. We should have scored, but
kicks away.
Andy's good from 55 or 60, so you know that man's good inside the 20. Ain't even got to worry about it. We ain't sweating. 34 to 10. Drove all the way down the field. Only walking away with 3 points. It is what it is.
Down he goes at the 17.
This is what the MTSU game should have looked like. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead.
I expect us or anyone to start out a little slow first game of the season, especially with a new OC and new DC.
They don't have the luxury of wasting drives.
Like, I actually expect that, and I'm not really super upset over it. As long as it starts.
And a quick throw.
Porter, though.
Tackle made at about the 33-yard line.
Why is Devontae having to run all the way across from the other side of the field to make a play on that guy? Porter is getting burned. I know he got that pick six. I know I said that I forgive him. Can't make the tackle. You're right. He's getting cooked.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up
they're
some
gonna,
great
they, they're figuring the it out, too. That's what sucks. They're figuring that out. Wait, what did Chris say? Oh, boy. They might score here, guys. If only the D-lines we faced all season were similar to Miami of Ohio's skill sets. One can dream, right? Chris, did you jinx it? I'll be honest, Aiden, I have the Nuggets winning. I'm sorry. I'm just trying to be realistic. Heat made a good run. I don't think anybody can beat the Nuggets, and I can't believe I'm saying that. Any thoughts on the conference switch in the future? I don't think it's quite as likely as people think. The ACC is going to make a push because they don't want to disappear. They don't want to lose Miami. They don't want to lose potentially Clemson, FSU. So we'll see. As much as the Big Ten makes sense, I don't want to travel to those areas. So, there we go. That's the thing. I don't want to be playing out, you know, games out in Cali and games out more out west. But, you know, that's a selfish reason.
It's up, and it's Quincy uprights.
But just being honest, I don't know, Kyle. I'm being real. I don't think the Heat get swept, but I don't think they beat the Nuggets.
He's to the 20.
I can tell why they have Rashard and Robbie back there, though, man.
And they just keep on going here in quarter number three.
The greatest thing you could say about these guys
is John Shields in the building.
They are moving the football and putting points up on the board.
What's going on, John?
Come back out with some confidence from having put
good to
the
see
field
you, man.
The last time.
All right, let's not let up.
That's a great tackle at the 14.
That's a loss of 9 on the play. That'll make it second and long.
Did you see them clapping in our face? Did y'all catch that? I don't know, Brandon. I hope that's what happens. Little pump from TVD. Sending it.
Going deep. It's intercepted. And they make the
My man, Jacoby, kind of just got trucked lead, after, look at this, number six gets the pick, trucks Jacoby, and then goes on about his day like that's just what he does. TVD forcing the ball there, trying to make something happen, putting it up, hoping that his guy could make a play. There's still a lot of time left in this game.
He's pushed out of
we got guys getting burnt.
Great touch by the quarterback. Floating that one right into his hands.
Do not let them sneak back into this. Good play, good play.
He's taken down.
At about the 27 we blew that up. Yard line.
When you're an option quarterback, you get used to getting popped pretty
quick. Would love to get Jacoby's right thoughts on that play. I'll bring him on tomorrow and ask him why he didn't high point that ball and ball on the catch that for TBD. It was so funny, Chris, because last year people were tagging players and posting clips from the virtual games on Twitter and being like, bro, why didn't you catch that? Why didn't you make that tackle? And then they would tag the player. And like I said, Restrepo was just shaking his head. He was laughing. If it's on James Williams again. Oh, it's on LT.
In a game like football, if you keep giving away opportunities like this, I guarantee you they'll come back to haunt you.
Ask him why he would let himself get trucked.
Down. He'll be looking for 6 points here.
I'm embarrassed for him. I have secondhand embarrassment. Boy, Devontae about took that one to the house. Everybody in this stream would have lost it if we would have had a second pick six. That one better would have been returned for almost 90 yards. Hey, good to see you, dude, Kay. Feels good to be back, man.
Tracy picks up about 4 yards on the play. It's third and goal.
Come on now.
Let's
hold him to a field goal attempt. Watch that left side, number 88 over there. No, running the ball. LT.
He's not going to get in.
Let's go. Hey, pockets for bugs. I appreciate you, man. We're just here to have fun. Hard Rock's bumping.
Kick is up, and he got it.
Okay. No more forcing the ball, TVD. I know we got to have guys open.
Looks like they're ready for the kick.
Got to be some of those receivers getting separation against these Miami of Ohio DBs. Right? Let's freaking go, Rashard. 37-yard return on the kickoff. Is Tyler Harrell 99 overall speed? I actually don't know.
After throwing a pick on their last
maybe not 99, but possibly close.
So these guys want
hey, thank you, John. It means a lot that you're here, for real.
Runs outside for a nice game.
Thank you, Michael. We're working on it. Not 100%, but we'll get there.
4 yards away here on second down. They'll line up with five.
Yeah, we could do that sometime, Jose. I've been on his channel, but I haven't had him over here on mine.
There's a missed tackle. Nice run there.
Tricky stuff here. Going with the misdirection to the fullback.
Parrish, 100 yards.
Nicely as they get the first down.
Running hard.
And he's tackled at the 44.
Thank you, Michael, for real.
2 yards away from the sticks.
Are you doing Dynasty or Play Now tomorrow? I'm just doing, it'll just be this, but I control it. It'll just be super chill.
Brought down at the 34.
Shaney thought he had one. I thought he had one too. Shoestring tackle, man. All he saw was green grass. You trying to sell your graded Pokemon card behind you? No, sir. Do you have one to sell to me, though?
Up the middle for a nice game.
But I'll buy it.
Yeah, I don't know what's up with that, Chalupa. I mean,
from the 30-yard line,
recruiting is such a finicky thing.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun.
It's just this constantly.
Fires to his receiver.
Wide open X-Man.
And he's taken down at the 18-yard line.
Well, you know this 2 for 24. No, only two receptions for XR7, but you making it count. For that. In that play, they made them pay. What's up? Percent. Look who we got in the building.
You heard?
The 10.
Come on, Parrish. Finish.
And he's shoved out of bounds.
If we don't punch this in. It's good to see the You Heard guys in the building. Come on. Come on, let's go.
My
siren arm is itching. It's itching and twitching. Let's punch this in. Give it to Chaney. What? Okay. That's not in?
One more quarter to play. This one appears.
That's not a touchdown?
34-16, Hurricane.
I could have swore that he fell into the end zone right there. I think we should have just handed it off to Chaney, man. All right, let me see him.
Welcome back to the
let me see him.
As we resume play here in quarter number four.
Kane's right here at the one-inch line. Let me see him. Final quarter of the first virtual game of the season. Let me see him. Come on.
Touchdown, Miami.
Y'all already know what time it is. Throw them U's up. Throw them U's up.
Let's go, man. I'm hype. Y'all ready to score a touchdown to start the fourth quarter? I can't think of a better way to kick this quarter off.
Where are you?
Joshua in the building.
Big Ten is expected to make 30 to 40 million payout over the ACC. For that much, I can stomach the long distance trips.
Hear me out though, Joshua. Hear me out. First of all, thank you for the $4.99. Second of all, I'm very happy to see you in here. Third of all, if we're talking that type of money, it is the right move for Miami from their point of view. Like, if you're in their shoes, of course you take that. For me, it's just selfish reasons because I don't want to go to away games over there. I just don't want to. Like, if it was SEC, it's places like, you know, Tennessee, Alabama, Florida. Like, that's my neck of the woods because I live in East Tennessee. So, like I said, it's a selfish reason. You know what I'm saying? But all the away games would be so much closer to me. If Miami goes Big Ten, it makes sense. It does. It's just frustrating. You know what I'm saying? I appreciate the love, Joshua. Thank you. Let's punch this in, y'all. Right here. You heard guys came in just in time to watch Chaney get a 0-yard touchdown.
Touchdown, Miami!
Well, the offense certainly did their job.
They extended the lead here
in the fourth quarter.
You guys know my neighbors are probably like, it's not September. What's happening over there? Just kidding. They love me. 41 to 16. We still ain't settling in.
This one's going to be down in the end.
Running back's eating tonight. You ain't kidding, Chalupa. Parrish looks good and healthy. Chaney's running hard. I love it. I freaking love it. What's up, Mitchell? You missed a heck of a game so far. Heck of a game. What's up, Ben? You missed this game. Hopefully next year it's back. From their own 29-yard line. It's second down. Now go with five tackles tonight so far.
Short over the middle.
Okay, big third down. About 5 yards on up 41-16. Man, we don't want to slow down. We want to build up momentum that carries through the rest of the season. Let's put 60 on these guys. Let's score two or three more touchdowns in the fourth quarter. Come on.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one.
Matthew, I do not reveal what's in the cup until the Miami Hurricanes win another national championship. So for now, it remains a mystery. Let's go. Somebody tackle that guy.
No one can bring him down. Gets to about the 37-yard line.
Brett who? First down. Excuse me? Would I be happy if this happened in real life? If you would have asked me this in the first quarter, Mitchell, I would have said, oh, heck no. But all in all, yes, I would be pretty content with this performance.
He gets out to about the 38.
Especially when, given what happened last year, Mitchell. Yeah, definitely, definitely.
From their own 38-yard line, second down.
Who's my favorite player, like as in right now, this year?
Tries to get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense.
Bro, Miami of Ohio, look at, they're tired, man. They're tired. Here's where you start to see the difference. LT just eating.
Well, they've converted.
Right here's where you start to see that gap.
Drive, but now they're faced with a third and long.
You would be okay with 16 points given up in the first half? Given the way the team performed last year,
and he can't get away from the
probably
pressure.
Fine as long as it ends up looking like this. I mean, all in all, I would say that Miami of Ohio should score 0 points against Miami. But after the way we played last year, I don't expect it to be all rainbows and unicorns this year. I don't think it's a complete 180, like a lot of other people believe.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long.
Just personally. So it's not that I'm happy per se, but I'm content. If it ends like this, Chris. Yeah, Johnny, it's a mystery.
Fields at the 41. Tackle at the 48.
Here we go. Run it up. Run it up.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience.
Yeah, I mean, again, I'm excited for Dawson. I'm excited for Guidry. But the chances of Miami going 12-0, winning the ACC championship, being in the college football playoffs, like, that would be very slim. It would be a miracle if that happened this year. We're working on it. I feel you, Chris. No, I mean, I feel you. We have the same one, Sean. Favorite Kane of all time is Devin Hester. Yep, same for me. Green screen.
Zips it to the back.
Harris still running hard in the fourth quarter. Doesn't look gassed. That's the same for me, Sean.
Try to change the field position with this kick. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the
I don't know if either side scores anymore the rest of the game, to be honest. We'll see. Greg Cooper, that's a good one. That's a good one.
Guys back in the studio,
I have too many fond memories of Devin Hester, Sean. Way too many.
He's doing a great job as a unit and not allowing this quarterback to get into any rhythm.
Well, all of his good plays have added up to
LT with three sacks tonight.
I don't expect any once in a lifetime rallies here.
Our dude.
That being said, we could still see some exciting plays.
Man, when's the last time we had an electric running back like that? A guy that every time he touched the ball, there was a chance he took it to the house. When, who was the last one? Like, I love DJ Dallas, but he wasn't on that level. I love Parrish. He's not on that level. I don't even know. I don't even put Travis Homer on that level, though, and I love that guy.
Do we know if we have any starters out with injuries for start of season?
The only one that I know of that seems like is probably going to be likely would be starters. Never mind, you said starters. Not that I'm aware of. I know that I've heard that there's been some setbacks with Trevante Citizen, but I don't expect him to crack that starting rotation again with a healthy Parrish. Healthy Don Chaney Jr. You do have Fletcher in the mix, even though he's a young guy. So, not that I know of right now. Not that's locked in, as this guy's not playing to start the season. Mark Walton is an underrated one. I mean, yeah, but do you put Mark Walton and Duke Johnson in the same sentence? Would you put Travis Homer and Duke Johnson in the same league when you're talking about like electric, explosive running backs? See, now I wouldn't put DJ Dallas in that, and I like DJ Dallas. I think Fletcher is that dude, Johnny, but I don't know about this year. We'll see. Yeah, see, we're just being real. It's not hate, guys.
Middle of the tight end. Tackle made around the 30,
I can't tell the difference between 88 and 89. They both look like tight ends.
It's first and
what's
10.
Up? It's a Canes thing.
34.
It's a Cane thing. I always add an S to the end of your name.
And it's caught. No comment, Chris.
You know how I feel.
That makes it second and 10. This is the eighth play of this drive.
DJ used to watch the channel, Chalupa.
Tackle at the 27.
I used to play games sometimes with them. With DJ and who else was it? Sheldrick, Redwine, Jaquan Johnson. Realist George would, too. He would jump in there. He's not a Cane anymore, but used to be.
Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds.
You all forgot who Chaney is? Heck no, I didn't, Raphael. Not me. A healthy Chaney is dangerous, but I understand people writing him off because he hasn't been able to consistently be on the field due to injuries. So I can't necessarily blame the fans.
Just under.
But I'm really hyped. There's so much potential there. Come on.
And he has it on the corner. Decides to slide.
Let's find out who's going to play four quarters. Yeah, I know you like Ja'Cory Chalupa. I have a Ja'Cory Harris jersey, actually.
The quarterback in the gun with five receivers.
Good tackle right there.
Well-designed route and a competent
solid tackle
by the quarterback.
Now, don't forget, guys, next week, Texas A&M is on the board.
They'll spread the field with five wide.
Come on, don't let them score. Come on, defense.
He's on the run. They bring him down.
Now, here's the question. Do they kick the field goal and take the points, or are they going for it? You're down 41-16. 2 minutes left in the game. Parrish had a good game tonight in the simulation. They're going for it. Here we go. Fourth and seven. Wide open.
And a quick throw. And it pays off. Touchdown.
I don't like that.
Nice grab by the halfback for the touchdown.
It was a short throw for the quarterback, but not easy. He made that play work.
They rolled the dice and went for it on fourth. And I'm sure they're happy with the result.
Well, I feel like James Williams kind of got lost in the sauce there.
And he adds the extra point.
And he couldn't close fast enough. What's up, Space Mountain? Oh, they tried the onside kick. They're not playing around.
It hasn't gone their way today, but they're going to continue to put up a fight. This is a proud program.
Yeah, there's no way that my expectation is a national championship. My realistic expectation.
Just under 2 minutes in the game. Feeds it to the back.
Yeah, guys. Hold on. Let me pause this. Jair Z. Bear must be a Florida State fan if I had to guess. And he says, you know it's a video game when there is actually fans in the stands. You know what? I have something for you. I have a reply to that comment.
Shut up, bitch! Oh my
God.
From the 38-yard line, it's second down.
All right, let's go. Foot on the gas. Parrish still lower in the boom. Bro. We're at a minute left in the fourth quarter, 41-23, and Parrish is still trucking people.
They go with a run, and he's going to be stopped short.
They're going to call it right there. No. We're gonna give Andy a shot.
Ahead of the snap count. Here's
wait
the
a minute. No. This ain't out of Andy's range.
Maybe
no. Mario, let Andy
huddle.
Do his thing. He can hit this. Bro! I would be
Joyce.
Living.
Try to kick this one deep. Let's see if he can get it inside the five.
If we kick the field goal right here. If we punted. You let Andy have his moment right there.
I'm sure that touchdown in their last possession's given them some confidence, but let's see if that carries them back down the field.
They're going to run a play.
This defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the pass.
They need to go 80 yards.
Slow it down.
Somehow get a touchdown in under 4 seconds, an onside kick, then another touchdown. 23. Then an onside kick and another. You keep playing though, so I get it.
Here they come. He airs it out. Almost picked off.
Game number one, 2023 virtual season.
And that should do it. Our final tally in this one: 41.
Miami Hurricanes getting the dub over Miami of Ohio. Look at LT, man. 9 tackles, 6 tackles for loss, and 4 sacks. My man, 8 tonight. A pick 6 from Porter. TVD very slow to get going, but once he got comfortable, very decisive, making decisions, slinging the ball, looking a little more like the TVD from 2 years ago,
this
but not quite to that caliber yet.
To where do you on the side of your helmet?
Easy to get fans in the stands when you get a degree driving through Trailer Hassie.
The comment speaks for itself. I don't need to add anything else to it. Joshua, thank you so much for the $4.99, my man. I'm not even going to add anything. I'm just going to leave it. And we have a new Canes fam member. And let me add Canes fam member level 2, Michael Bird. Thank you so much for the love. Thank you for joining the Canes fam. Enjoy that you by your name and those Canes fam member only emotes. I appreciate that, Michael. Welcome to the fam. Miami Hurricanes getting the dub, 41-23. Honestly, pretty happy with the game overall with how the virtual team performed. I will take that again given what happened last year. Did you guys enjoy this for all the new people? There were a ton of people jumping in tonight that said, Coop, I've never been a part of this. I don't even know exactly what this thing is, but I want to hang out for a bit and see what it's all about. There's usually anywhere from 200 to 500 people in here, and I'm telling you, it just gets more and more exciting. Just think about this schedule. honestly, look at this thing. Texas A&M next week. We have Temple on the schedule, who talked mad trash about Miami. Wrote an entire article about me and me dogging their team. We got Clemson at Hard Rock. We got the FSU rematch happening late. Last game of the season, Boston College in Chestnut Hill. This is going to be an insane virtual season, and it's going to be so much fun. I'm telling you, you're not going to want to miss it. You are not going to want to miss this one. Going to be really freaking fun this year. I'm glad you enjoyed it, Chalupa. I'm glad you, Miami of, oh no, no Pitt this year. Nope, no Pitt this year. So this starts the divisionless ACC, which means things are going to get wonky. It's going to get wild, and it's going to get weird. So we're going to see what happens. I'm going to kick your butt. Hey, I appreciate you, Michael. Thank you so much for the love tonight. Thank you, bro. Caleb Morris coming through here at the tail end of this thing. Re-upping the Canes fan membership for 26 months. Caleb, thank you for the love, bro. We'll let it play its thing up here. Who is Temple? No idea. And even, you know, I told that guy that wrote the article, I was like, I'm happy that the seven Temple fans, you know, have someone who covers the team so they have something to read. You know, he posts articles like daily. So I'm very happy for them. It's insane to think that some of these teams like Florida State and some of these bigger schools can't have more people pumping out content for them. But Temple has a guy that's writing articles every day. Pretty wild, right? Eric, I appreciate the love tonight, man. Thank you for that.
We ballin', boy.
There it is. There it is, Caleb. So, yeah, tomorrow.
We ballin', boy.
Brandon, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me, Brandon?
Brandon Frick!
Re-upping the Canes fan membership, but upgrading it to level 3. My man Brandon does not play around. Thank you so much for the love, man. I appreciate that. As I said, I'm going to work on, you know, last year we did for Canes fan members, we started doing those late night real talks on Sunday nights. Obviously, I had a bunch of crazy stuff happen in my life with family stuff. Those went away for a bit. I'm going to try to do some bigger and better things for Canes fan members this season coming up. And think about it, it's already June. So literally, we start ramping everything up in August. So it's going to be coming real soon. But again, don't forget, guys, tomorrow I'll also do the Coop Plays version of this. So tomorrow night at 9 p.m. Eastern time, Miami Hurricanes are going to play Miami of Ohio again, except I'll be controlling Miami. It won't go down as anything official like this one does, but it's just going to be for fun. So it'll be super chill. We can all hang out and just vibe and just chat it up. You know, I can pause the game whenever since I'll be playing it. And you guys can critique my gameplay and tell me how much I suck at it. You can suggest plays, all that good stuff. It should be fun. And as I said, this isn't going to become some kind of gaming channel. It's just, it's the offseason. So we're just trying to enjoy it.
Temple isn't even the best owl. FAU is.
This is what it take.
You about made me spit my drink out, Joshua.
On the side of your helmet.
Sorry, I had a first and third grade graduation and dinner, but I'll be here next week.
Almost made me spit my drink out, Joshua. Thank you for $1.99, man. I'm thinking about doing a diss track on Temple. Should I do that? Like, every year I pick a big team. I do, like, Texas A&M, Alabama, LSU. If Temple's gonna talk trash, I don't think it'll get a lot of views. I'll do a diss track on Temple. No, I don't jinx it. Bro, listen. We've not lost every game I've done a diss track for. All right? Caleb also coming through with the $4.99. Sorry I had a first and third grade graduation and dinner, but I'll be here next week. You're good, Caleb. You don't have to apologize, man. Obviously, family comes first, especially if it involves the kids and stuff. So, hey, man, I appreciate the love, and I just appreciate it, man. Thank you. Put you on stream? Why would I put you on stream? Huh? I don't know who Erica Miller is. Why would I? Huh? I don't know who this person is. I've never seen them before. Anyways. So, yeah. Awesome time tonight on the first game. And we'll have a good time tomorrow as well. I'm trying to think if there was anything else to add before we close this stream up. Because, again, these go for about an hour and a half. I think that's how long it was tonight. Yep. Ended right at about an hour and a half on the dot. Eric is spelled with a K. Koofy. I don't even know what they're talking about. Where did they come from and what are they talking about? There's probably not much else to do in Temple than write articles. Fair. Fair. Are you going to play the BCU game this year or skip the FCS game like last year? So, Sean, we are going to have to skip Bethune again this year. I know it kind of sucks because it's one less simulated game. And, you know, there's ways to do like this wonky team builder stuff and you can go in and make adjustments and stuff. But every time I do, it bugs the game. And what's more important to me is consistency and stability over trying to push a game against an FCS opponent like Bethune that we beat 70-13 last year in a season that we went 5-7. So I'm going to assume a dub against Bethune. We all know what happens when you assume things, but it's Bethune. If we can handle them last year by, you know, more than 50 points, I think we'll be okay. No resets for bugs this year. I agree, Cypher. And that's why people kept asking me, Coop, how come you don't upgrade to this version? Coop, how come you don't find a way to build a team and put Bethune in it? Coop, how... Stability. I need this to run smooth. I need no hitches. Zero hiccups, so that way we hit play and it does exactly what it did tonight. We had zero issues. Nothing wonky, nothing crazy. I felt like the offense actually was pretty good. Let's look at the stats. Let's look at the stats real quick. For those of you that are sticking around. I think overall, let's look at the team stats first. Miami ran the ball 36 times and threw for 24. So we actually ran the ball more. But again, you got to go with the hot hand. You got to do what's working, and we were running the ball well. Think about it at the beginning of the game. Tyler Van Dyke was struggling. He started out, what, 1 of 5 or 1 of 6 for 2 yards? You start handing the ball off to Parrish and Chaney. They're ripping off, you know, 8, 10, 12-yard runs. You're going to run the ball more, so that makes sense. Third down conversion was kind of bad. 4 of 10. We just had the one turnover, the pick by TVD, when he was trying to pass to Jacoby. Let's look at individual stats. Let's see who stood out in this game. Let's see the rushing yards. TVD, 15 of 24 for 195, 3 touchdowns, 1 pick, 62% completion percentage. I know what you guys are looking at. You're looking at the overall. You're looking at the stats on the players. I know what you're looking for. You can see I'm not running it up. Parrish, 119 in triple digits, 6.2-yard average per carry. Had it ripped off a 22-yarder. Chaney, though, 10 for 68, 6.8-yard average per carry and the touchdown. That's big time, man. If we could do that, man, I'd be so freaking happy. Who was the top receiver? Colby, because he had that huge one, man, that 59-yarder. 2 for 90. Jacoby, 2 for 6. Didn't see a ton from Restrepo, but he made them count. 2 for 24 is pretty solid. Robbie had a catch. Ray had one. McCormick targeted a lot. We didn't get to see Arroyo or Skinner make some catches tonight, but still pretty happy with that. What do we have defensively? I know Leonard Taylor led the way, man. 9 total tackles, 6 tackles for loss, 4 sacks. Harvey with 3. Besanth with 1. So what, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 sacks tonight. Malik Curtis saw the field a bit. Porter, though, we got to work on him getting burnt, bro, for real. Sheesh. We got to work on that. And Gore had a sack. So 9 sacks tonight. Is that 9 total? It's not showing all the players if they didn't get in the game. This is just a player that, saw snaps, and he didn't see any snaps in this game. So it is what it is. I'm kind of surprised, but he didn't. He's in there. He's in the game. So, what's going on, Christopher Jackson? Good to see you, man. So that's going to wrap up tonight's stream. Really, really good time, man. Tom Dono of the night, Chris Gaffney coming in with the $9.99. I appreciate the support from everybody, man. All the new Canes fan members that re-upped, all the donations, everybody, man. Thank you for that. I'll see you guys tomorrow for the Coop Plays version of this, and then we'll continue this every Friday after this. So we will change this. The scrolling text, we got to change it. Miami is 1-0, currently undefeated. Not mad about it. Miami is 1-0 in the virtual season. Taking on the big bad Aggies next week, though. 17-9 last year. We're going to score a single touchdown. I think there's a chance that we might actually put it in the end zone next week. I hope so, man. Let's wrap this thing up the way that we always do. Come on. I know the regulars know what's up. I know you guys know how we end this. Show the people that haven't been around what we do. Come on now. I need somebody to lead the way. Show them the way. You're saying. Oh, there's a chance, Sean. There's a chance. I hope we can win next week. But you'll have to show up right here to find out. Give me a big, fat, all caps. Go Canes! I'll see y'all tomorrow, 9 p.m. Be there. Or don't. Your choice.